With the demands currently on ports, I really don't see crane design changing drastically in the near future. I think we'll continue to see the cranes get bigger in order to accommodate the larger vessels, but terminals as a whole are rather conservative in their approach. Nobody wants to be first, or very few want to be first. So we see a lot of potential innovations that have come up in the market lately, and they don't really gain traction and they don't really go anywhere. So I think we will continue to see more automation. We will continue to see adjustments for that automation, but I don't see a major overhaul of the crane design. AI means to me really machine learning and machine self-improvement. And you get that through data processing and data analytics. And it's really nothing new. It's not new to TMEIC and it's not really new to the industry. We've been working with it since the late 80s, doing self-improvement, product improvement in other industries. And we've been doing a lot of research into expanding our process models and into neural networks. And we've had some really good successes with landside automation. Our landside automation system relies on the modeling of chassis. I think we will see it continue to develop in the port industry. And it's really important to recognize that artificial intelligence relies on data. So there really is a connection between big data and artificial intelligence, and we will see them grow together in the future. So what terminals can do to improve overall is they really need to form a vision for the future. And then once they have that vision, they see this is where we want to go. They need to have the commitment to set aside the money and the resources in measurable steps so that they actually can achieve that vision. A lot of terminals focus on improvements. So they ask things like, how can I electrify my RTGs? What can I do for my gate system to improve truck turn time? And these are very important. Improvements are essential, but they aren't looking to innovate. So before you can look for improvements, you need to ask the innovative question. Do I need to get rid of my RTG fleet? What do I need to do to move it to full automation? Can I retrofit the existing equipment, or should I plan to get new equipment? And really form that long-term goal before you look for the short-term goals.